الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله
how sad it may be, that we have to ask, what are the conditions and the qualities and the characteristics of those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will use to aid his deen. What are the characteristics of those who Allah will use to aid his deen? Allah ta'ala, he promises in the Quran, and the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is true. Allah says, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Allah Ta'ala, he promises in the Quran. He promises and he says that Allah promises, and he states his own promise, that Allah promises those who believe from amongst you and those who do righteous actions that they will be given leadership, succession, authority, dominion in the earth, just as those who came before them from the previous nations, when they believed in Allah and supported the deen of their prophet, were given leadership, succession, and authority in the earth. It's the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That those who believe, number one, that they believe in Allah and do righteous actions, that they will begin again receive leadership in the earth. It's the promise from Allah. وَلِمَكِنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمْ أَلَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ. And Allah says he will make the deen that he's pleased with for them to become firm and settled in the earth. It's not going anywhere, alhamdulillah. The deen of Allah will never vanish from the earth until the hour is established. It's the promise from Allah. And it's something that should make our hearts be happy. And then Allah, he tells us something. وَلِيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا. Allah says he will exchange the fear that they're in to be safety. It's the reality that many of the Muslims, they're in a state of fear. A state of fear when it comes to outwardly stating and practicing the deen of Allah. They're in a state of fear not knowing if they're going to be branded and labeled and called things and despised because of the deen that they're practicing. The beautiful deen of Islam that we're upon. But people are afraid now. That just because I say I'm a Muslim, will I be singled out? Will I be called bad names? Will I be attacked because of my belief in Islam? Allah says he will change that fear that the Muslims have to a state of safety. When the Muslims, they feel safe to be Muslims again. When will this be, barakallahu feekum? Allah says, يَعْبُدُونَنِي وَلَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. When they begin worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, when they return to having pure tawheed and their heart is attached to Allah, that their fear is only for Allah, their hope is only for Allah, that they worship Allah, not going to the graves and seeking help, not calling on help and assistance from anyone that's passed away or dead, but their heart is firmly attached to tawheed. And when they do not commit shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything, when they do not give their rights that belong purely to Allah, to anything or anyone besides Allah. Then and only then will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them safety and security in the earth. As Allah ta'ala says, لَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْسَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Look at the condition Allah sets for us. Don't weaken, don't become weak and give up on your path. And don't grieve, don't become sad over the situation that you might be in today. Because you will be superior if you are truly believers. You will be superior. The believers will be superior. But the question we have to ask and we have to struggle for is that we have to prefer our iman over everything else. We have to be willing to truly believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His promise and fear nothing besides Allah. As Allah ta'ala, He mentions in the Quran, أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِالظُّلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنِ وَهُمْ مُحْتَدُونَ. Allah Ta'ala, He says, those who believe in Allah, and they don't allow that belief in Allah to be mixed with any dhulm. Linguistically, we know dhulm to mean oppression. That when you oppress someone or something, and it's how the Sahaba, when they heard this ayah, they understood it as well. But Allah Ta'ala says, those who believe and they don't allow their iman to be mixed with any type of oppression, they will be the ones who, Allah Ta'ala says, they will have safety and they will be those who are guided. They will be those who have safety in the akhirah and as well in the dunya. They will be safe in the Akhirah from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from committing shirk, from being in the fire forever, from being punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They'll be safe from this. And in the dunya, they'll be safe from the enemies of Allah. They'll be safe and they'll be superior in the earth. And they will be upon guidance. And they will be upon guidance. There comes in the tafsir of this ayah on authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. He said, لَمَّا نَزَلَتْ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ شَقَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى النَّاسِ فَقَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَأَيُّنَا لَا يَظْلِمُ نَفْسَهُ قَالَ إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ الَّذِي تَعْنُونَ أَلَمْ تَسْمَعُوا مَا قَالَ الْعَبْدُ الصَّالِحُ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ إِنَّمَا هُوَ الشِّرْكُ. The companions, when they heard this ayah, they said it was difficult for them to bear this ayah. They were worried because they knew. They said, Ya Rasulullah, which from amongst us, who from amongst us has not ever committed any sins? When they heard oppression, they thought this meant that they were sinful to themselves. Who from amongst us has not oppressed himself? And the Prophet ﷺ, he informed, it's not what you're thinking. It's not what you're thinking. Have you not heard the ayah? Have you not heard the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that was said by the righteous servant, meaning Luqman? That indeed shirk is a great form of oppression. And the Prophet ﷺ, he informed him that that which is meant in this ayah, لَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ, that they do not allow their iman to be mixed with any form of oppression. That which is meant here is shirk. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising for the brothers to, I see the band is filling up. You can go upstairs. The upstairs is open and prepared for the brothers to go as well, inshallah. So if it's full in the overflow room, they can go upstairs and it's prepared for them to go, inshallah. That those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to have tamkeen, to have firmness in the earth, safety in the earth, authority in the earth, it is those who, number one, believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they do not commit any shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They free themselves, their families, their communities, their countries from worshipping anything besides Allah. And yes, wallahi, this is present in the lands of the Muslims. And we wonder why our situation is as it is. When our hearts are not properly attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when a person has a situation of stress and a hardship, sometimes they go and ask for help from other than Allah. And either someone is doing it themselves, or the people are lax in warning against it. The people are lax in warning against the greatest crime that happens on earth. It's a shirk. To worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's as if it doesn't occur. As-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he says that for to achieve these two promises of safety and guidance, that a person must do the first two things. They must believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they must free their lives, their hearts, their acts of worship from any form of shirk. If a person does not do these first two things, they will not achieve safety and guidance in the earth. There's no promise of that except for those who are able to do the first two. أَقُولُ قُولِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد خاتم النبيين وآله وصحبه أجمعين ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. In the first khutbah we mentioned that authority and dominion in the earth, it comes first from believing in Allah and not committing any shirk. After this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the next ayah, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةُ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةُ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Allah, he mentions three more characteristics that we should be aware of. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةُ. Allah says, upstairs is open, brothers. If there's no room in the back, upstairs is open. Jazakumullahu khairan. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةُ. Allah ta'ala says that they establish the salah. Not meaning that they just pray. A lot of times people, they get up and they rush through the acts of ibadah. They say, I prayed. That's not what Allah commanded us to do. Allah commanded us to establish the salah. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةُ. Meaning, to establish the salat with all of its pillars and requirements, to be amongst those who, when you're praying, you're focused on the fact that you're standing in front of Allah. Allah commands us, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ, and seek help and assistance in your act, whatever you're going through of difficulties. If we're not in a difficulty in our dunya or our akhirah, this is the salat is what's going to help, inshallah. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. And Allah said, that's something that's difficult. Except for those, when they enter the salat, they have khushu'. And some of the ulama, they say, how do you have khushu' in the salat? They say, by practicing khushu' outside of the salat. Preparing yourself daily, every time before you come to the salat, actually remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Preparing yourself mentally before the salat. Making the salat one of the most important parts of your day. If you do this, then in the salat you will have khushu'. If you do this, the salat will change your life. But if the salat is a burden to you, and it's just something to do, then I have to pray. Oh, I prayed already. And this is not the salat that's going to change the ummah. It is not the type of salat that's going to change your life. It's not the salat that's going to change anything, barakallahu feekum. And then worse than this, wa'iyadu billah, we have some people who say they're Muslims, and they don't pray at all. They don't even get up to pray the salawat. And they think that victory and authority and dominion in the earth is going to come on the backs of the likes of these. That they abandon the salawat and they don't think about salat until maybe Jumu'ah or Ramadan that they want to pray. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he promises, he said, "Inna bayna al-rajli wa bayna al-shirk wal-kufr tark as-salat." That between a person being upon kufr and shirk, and a person being upon Islam, the one thing that separates a person between shirk and kufr and Islam is tark as-salat, is abandoning the salat. Once you abandon the salat, there's no more iman left. There's nothing more to stop you from doing any and everything. The salat is the last shield between a person entering into kufr. Before a person enters into shirk, there's nothing left after this. So Allah Ta'ala, he tells waqimu salat, that you establish the salah. Upstairs is open, inshallah. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةِ. Now how many times do we see Allah Ta'ala, he couples, he brings these two together, the establishment of the salah and paying of the zakat. When Uthman radiallahu anhu was being attacked by those Khawarij individuals, he mentioned how much sadaqah he gave for the sake of Islam as a proof, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, sadaqah to Burhan. That sadaqah, giving sadaqah from your heart, spending that which people love after they've earned from it. Sadaqah is a proof of iman. Do we not see that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when those groups of individuals refused to give the zakat after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I will fight them even if they don't give one sheep that they used to give to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because this again, barakallahu feekum, is from that which grants authority and dominion in the earth. We have to give from that which we want, from that which we hold on to. Because the deen won't be established unless we dig deep in our pockets to pay for that which is needed. It's the reality. And the last of that which we'll mention. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in this ayah, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. And obey the messenger so that you may receive mercy. Obedience to the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not leaving off his sunnah for that of anyone else. Obeying the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and not just again saying it's just sunnah. I don't have to do that. Oh, the Prophet did it this way, but such and such does it this way. Obeying the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and holding firm to his sunnah brings authority and dominion in the earth. It brings safety in the earth. It brings guidance to the people because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the one who was sent to show us how to be human beings. Where Allah Ta'ala, he tells us, فَلْيَحْذِرَ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Allah Ta'ala, he warns us. Let those who oppose the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let them be warned. فَلْيَحْذِرَ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ. Let those who oppose the way of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who leave off the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was sent the last and final messenger, let those who go against that, let them be warned of a fitna that might come to them. Al-Dahaq, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that this fitna here is kufr. يطبع على قلبه, that their heart will be concealed. فلا يأمن أن يظهر بلسانه الكفر. So they will not become safe from being safe from manifesting on their tongues statements of kufr, and on their limbs actions of kufr, because they oppose the way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Going against the way of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam exposes you to kufr, exposes you to fitna. So when we say hold on to the way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, this is hold on with everything that you have. This is our safety and security, barakallahu feekum. Again, five main characteristics that the people who will be given authority and dominion in the earth, those will be given khilafah in the earth. What is the characteristics that they have? Allah Ta'ala says that they will believe in Allah and they will not commit shirk. They will establish the salat, they will pay the zakat, and they will follow the way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to make us amongst those who receive the promise of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. اللهم أرنا الحق الحق وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل الباطل وارزقنا اجتنابه ولا تجعله ملتبسا علينا فنضل ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك وأتوب إليك وأقم الصلاة Thank you.